we will create a transaction to record tourist attractions. This transaction will be called attraction. For each tourist attraction, we've been asked to enter its name, the country where it's located, a photo, and a category that describes if it is a monument, a museum, a show, and so on. The key attribute of this transaction will be called attraction ID. We should always remember to type a dot so that GeneXus suggests a prefix and we can avoid typing mistakes. We complete the key attribute name and set its type as a numeric of 4 digits, just like we did with the customer identifier, customer ID. As we will probably need to create more identifiers, it would be a good idea to create a common data type for all identifiers. For instance, a type that we may call ID and is a numeric value of 4 digits. The data type created by us is called domain. For example, once we've created the ID domain, we can set several attributes to ID type, and they will all be 4-digit numeric values. One advantage it provides is that if later on we need identifiers to be numeric of length 6 instead of numeric of 4, changing the domain definition will be enough to update all the attributes based on that domain in a single step. To create this, we press the tab key, and in the type column we write ID equals N, which is then auto-completed with numeric. We leave the 4-digit value suggested by default. After pressing enter, we can see that the attraction ID attribute has now been set as ID type. Let's take a look at the properties of the attraction ID attribute. If we're positioned on the attraction ID attribute and press F4, this window will display several settings made for this attribute and will allow us to change them. We can see that it's based on the ID domain, and for this reason, it's a 4-digit numeric value. Note that properties can be sorted alphabetically. And here we can see the autonumber property. This property is set to false by default, and if we change it to true, all the new attractions entered will be automatically numbered in sequence. This is to say that every time that a new attraction is added, the attraction ID attribute will be automatically assigned a new number that's bigger than the last existing number. So, we're setting the autonumber property specifically for this attraction ID identifier attribute. Another option would be to set the same property for the ID domain that we've created, so that when we create more transaction identifier attributes, we can assign them the ID domain. In this way, they would inherit all the domain definitions, such as the data type and all the properties configured. To see the domains created, we edit the domains window. From here, we can create and edit domains in a similar way to how we create attributes. We click on the ID domain, and the properties window is refreshed to show this domain's properties. We find the autonumber property and set it to true. This will cause all ID type attributes to be automatically autonumbered in sequence. We go back to the structure window of the attraction transaction and start to create its second attribute. We add the attraction name attribute. We also create the name domain of character type, length 50. And we set the name type for the attraction name attribute. Now we need an attribute to register the country of the tourist attraction. We could create an attribute called attraction country as character 50, and then enter the country name when adding details. Now, what happens if we want to enter two tourist attractions from the same country? We should enter the same country name twice, and be careful to type it exactly the same. Later on, we might need to search for all the attractions in a certain country, and to get them, the country must have been typed exactly the same way every time. Let's take a look at this case. Suppose that we've entered several attractions with their corresponding countries. For example, we have an attraction with identifier 1, called Louvre, located in France, an attraction with identifier 2, called the Great Wall and located in China, and another attraction with ID equals 3, the Eiffel Tower, which is also in France. We know that the Louvre is located in France, and that the Eiffel Tower is also in France, but due to a typing or spelling mistake, we entered the country name differently. Here we typed France with two N's. So for the system, this country is not the same as the other one. For this reason, this solution cannot be used. It seems more reasonable to enter the country only once, in a single location, and then for each attraction make reference to the corresponding country. This is to say, we should define something like this. One location where countries are stored. And in attractions, we make reference to the corresponding country identifiers. The Louvre is in France, country 2. The Great Wall is in China, country 3. And the Eiffel Tower is in France, also 2. To do this in GeneXus, we will create a transaction to record the countries. And then we will see how to assign a country to each transaction. Meanwhile, we save the attraction structure that we haven't completed. Note that it's indicated visually that this object is pending to be uploaded to GeneXus server. We'll leave it like this for now, because we will need to upload this change together with other changes that will be made in the following video.